Hi, I'm Bri-Mathias Hodge. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Electrical, Computer, and Energy Engineering and a fellow of the Renewable and Sustainable Energy Institute. In my research group, we do modeling and simulation of power and energy systems, and our goal is really to put as much renewable energy as possible into the power system. The power system is an enormous system. People don't like you to directly experiment with it. They don't like it if their lights go off just because you know you're testing out a new technology. So a lot of the work we do is modeling and simulation, and we can study very large systems in silico so that when we make those changes to the system, it doesn't cause reliability issues such as blackouts. We're working with the Electricity Reliability Council of Texas, so they run the power grid for basically all of Texas, on incorporating probabilistic solar forecasting into their operations. So a probabilistic forecast is like you get from the meteorologist, right? There's a 10% chance of rain today. How we use that in solar forecasting is we say things like, there's a 90% probability you'll have more than 500 megawatts of solar tomorrow. So in Texas, they're getting a lot more solar photovoltaics coming online. And in order to deal with that uncertainty and variability of that, they're now taking probabilistic forecasts of solar power, and they want to be able to use that in their operations in order to understand what other generation should turn on, should turn off based on that. And so we've been working with them for a couple years now on not only producing better forecasts of the solar energy, but then what they can do with those better forecasts. So if you say there's a 90% probability that you have 500 megawatts of solar generation tomorrow at noon, what does that mean? Does that mean you can turn off this coal plant, or do you still have to keep it on because of that 10% probability that it might not be there? And so we're working with them in order to automate those decision-making processes. I have a joint appointment between the National Renewable Energy Lab and CU Boulder. For me, it's a great opportunity to bring together the academic environment with the industrial experience that folks at NREL have. And it's great not only because of the collaborations that I can establish with people at NREL who are experts and their connections with utilities and people who are actually implementing renewable energy technologies, but also because of the great lab facilities that are really unique and allow us to do experiments that we wouldn't be able to do anywhere else. So an important part of this energy and power systems modeling is, what do people do with this information? And it's typically not engineers who are working with this information, it's policymakers. And so being able to visualize something so that a policymaker can understand the implications of the policies that they're creating is a very powerful tool toward adopting and establishing policies that are useful for all the different stakeholders.